Well, my faith story begins with the absolute blessing of being born in a Christian home. My parents were married for 54 years before my dad's death. My mother continues to be a prayer warrior for my family, a prayer intercessor. My father was from that generation that didn't talk a lot, but when he did, he was able to share his experiences, his wisdom with my brother and myself. I vividly remember some of the conversations we had. He was able to share some positive experiences with me, some mistakes where he had made, and I was able to learn from that. Even though my parents were Christian, I realized at a point I had to make my decision for Jesus. As Pontius Pilate said, "What should I do with this Jesus?" Well, I clearly understood that the plan of salvation is not a family plan. I've heard Dr. Danny say that numerous times. So as a young high school student, I trusted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. And from that moment, He's never left me, and He has been faithful, as the Bible says He will be. And so that promise has been fulfilled. I'm very thankful that God has placed some wise people into my life to serve as mentors. From their wisdom and from their experiences, I've learned to grow, to be a better husband to Carol, a better parent, a better friend, and most importantly, a more trusting and faithful Christian. I know that I have to be accountable to God to continue to grow in these areas. The life verse that I return to often is Psalms 51:10, creating me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Carol and I are surrounded by good Christian friends. And like most families, we've had our ups and downs, and Christian friends came alongside us and offered to pray for us, offered to help do small things around our household while we were focused on those other areas. One recent example is when our daughter Rebecca decided to move to Kenya. Our initial reaction was one of concern for her safety, but I can recall vividly many people within the church would come up to us and say, "I'm going to pray for her during that time." And those were promises that they kept, because during that time, I would have people come up and say, "I have your daughter's picture on my refrigerator, and I pray for her." One gentleman told me one day that, "I have her card, her picture, in my Bible. So I see it every time I open my Bible." You know, it's one thing to come up to me and say, "Hey, I'm praying for you in a difficult time." But if you're going to pray for my child during those times, to me, that's just priceless. The two-year adventure that Rebecca had in Kenya was just life-changing for her, and so we're so pleased that she got to enjoy that time. I know that every day she was away from us, God was in control, God did protect her, God did keep her safe during that time, so we are eternally grateful for that. My name is Monty Gordon, and that's my faith story.
This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.